Hi, my name is Paolo Gaudenzi. I'm from Rome, Italy, and I'm at the University of Rome alla Sapienza, where I'm serving as a full professor of aerospace structures, but I'm also the director of the Master in Satellites, or Master in Satellite Systems and Services. Now I would like to show how we perform the implementation of this facility at an educational level at La Sapienza, and some of the studies that we have performed in the recent years. We have even a software tool called Concurrent Design Tool at La Sapienza in order to enable year by year the students of our professional master in satellites to enter the tool and to work in this system engineering environment. As I told you before, we have the organization of a concurrent engineering design facility taken from the original software by the European Space Agency, and the architecture is based on interlinked Excel workbooks. In each workbook, there is an area of competence that is represented, and in each set of worksheets, you have input, output worksheet, and also calculation worksheet inside. We have developed one workbook for each subsystem, that is attitude control system, data handling, payload, power, propulsion, structure, TT&C, and thermal. Then we have one workbook considering mission, then one considering system, one for configuration, and then there is a way of doing the data exchange with a proper data exchange workbook. In each workbook, we have four different types of worksheets. The input worksheets collects data from all subsystems. The output worksheets gather results and send them to data exchange workbook. Then we have the calculation worksheet that process data. And we have also presentation worksheet, before called also administration worksheets, that are auxiliary worksheets to help the user better understand data and manage data during calculations. We were also able, of course, to let this structure to interact with other professional software that are also commercially available, like SDK or AutoCAD or PRICE or structural analysis software like ADINA. All those softwares are present on the market and are patented by their owner. So I would like to show you some case studies that we were able to study during the activity of the Master in Satellites and Space Services. Namely, here we might go through a list of different missions, like a geostationary telecommunication satellite mission, a low Earth orbit synthetic aperture radar satellite, some scientific missions in terms of constellation, some lunar observation mission, so even some interplanetary mission for the exploration of Titan, and some also low Earth orbit constellation for client mission data relay. At the end of the presentation, I will provide you some reference to go to the papers or to the documents by which you can enter this topic and maybe deepen your knowledge about each of those studies. So we, at the starting years of our Master in Satellite, we started with a geostationary mission, and so the aim of the study was just to develop a communication satellite aimed at providing North America and Europe with wideband broadcasting services such as video, telephony, and data. We made a trade-off study with different solutions, and here I'm just illustrating some of the outcomes of our study that, of course, is illustrated in a big report and in a presentation which you can follow all the details. With the FINGERSAT mission studied after the geostationary mission, we put our emphasis on a mission that is like the ones of Cosmos SkyMed, or like the ones of the Sentinels of Copernicus European Space Agency project. In this case, the payload is a quite special one, that is to say a synthetic aperture radar that poses a lot of challenging decision to the project. So for this satellite, the payload itself has to be studied in detail, and also and we perform not only the study and the design for all the subsystem of the bus, but also in terms of the subsystem of the payload itself. Then we studied other missions like the FLORAD missions, that is addressing the study for the tropospheric thermodynamical profile and the hydrological content on Earth atmosphere. And the project is based on a constellation of microsatellites with a special passive payload able to detect the information about the atmosphere that I just mentioned. In this case, we were able to make a study on a constellation of small satellites. Then there were other missions, for instance, LIRAS is a lunar observation mission for the high resolution mapping and vertical sounding of the moon subsurface. I would also mention a mission named TAIL, an interplanetary mission to travel towards Titan and land on one of its lakes. This mission was also presented to NASA scientists that were doing a study exactly with the same objectives. As a final effort, we recently deployed a study called the EOSS, Earth Orbiting Support System, by which we were able to propose a low Earth orbit constellation as a data relay backbone intended to support client low Earth orbit satellites in data transfer and TDNC. Our infrastructure in this case would work in a system of systems logic, allowing instant programming and data transfer, finding the appropriate path to the Earth observation spacecraft via the appropriate Earth observation support system node wherever the satellite is located around the Earth. So by doing that, we will overcome some of the limitations and time latencies currently existing, expecting with respect to Earth observation missions in terms of revisit time. So with such infrastructure permanently deployed in space, we might address and solve the problem of revising time that make Earth observation applications not so useful in practice because of the delay between the command issued from ground to take some picture of some places and the time when the picture made by satellites is all it's actually issued to ground once again. These are just examples. These are examples on how a concurrent design facility, even one at the educational level like we have at La Sapienza, might work in order to provide a sound and well-organized design for the purpose of developing an entire space system. Once again, concurrent engineering will help a lot in having well-directed design choices, reducing the time of design development, and reducing also the risk of making decisions at the early stage of projects that are not aligned with the analysis of cost. Once again, costs are determined in the first phases of the development of a space project, and as soon as we provide the most effective, shared, coordinated project, the less is the risk of bad decision or a bad evaluation of the cost for the entire satellite system. So in conclusion, concurrent design procedures are needed for designing space systems of the present time and of the time of the future, allowing all this multidisciplinary effort to be placed in an efficient way in order to obtain systems that are really effective to produce the results of the mission that they are supposed to perform.